Keeping your lens safe, making it darker and having sunglasses for your lens or some polarization? Let's talk about filters in front of your lens. Maybe you have heard of filters that you can put in front of your lens. There are actually a couple different ones. You have the UV filter, you have the ND or neutral density filter, and you have polarization filters. And maybe there are a couple more, but these are the most commonly used ones or the ones you hear the most about. I tend to use at least one of them, and that is the UV filter. The UV filter actually was a kind of important filter back in the day, because then the film actually did not handle the UV by itself. Nowadays, the sensors actually already handle the UV, so the UV part of this filter is actually not really necessary. But the great thing about UV filters is that they tend to be kind of cheap, and that way they are great filters to kind of put on your lens and never take off, just to protect the front element of your lens. Because if you scratch the filter, you can just switch it out. But if you actually scratch the front of your lens, you might not be able to do that. So in my case, I have a filter in front of all of my lenses, and I just buy the filter whenever I buy the lens, and then I just clean the lens inside, clean the filter inside, screw them together, and basically never take them off. And that is also the reason why I am not going to take off this filter to show you, because it just stays on there, and that way I kind of have a better chance of not getting any dust between the lens and the filter. But the thing with these kind of protective filters is that you do not want to use cheap filters. And that is kind of true across the board, but especially with these always-on filters, you don't want to have a cheap filter in front of your glass. The main reason for that is because it's the first element that the light goes through. So if you have a very cheap glass in front of your lens and that the light goes through that glass, it then goes into the lens, and from there it goes onto the sensor. But if it actually is cheap glass, it can really have either a distorting or reflective effect, or maybe even reduce the light in terms of the strength, so you don't really get the same result afterwards. For me, a rule of thumb is that I spend around 10% of the lens price also on the filter. So if the lens is around 800 euros, I might get a filter that is around 80 euros. So far that worked out pretty nicely for me. In my case, for the size lenses, I actually bought the size filters as well. And for this one, I bought a Oya filter, which is also a nice filter. And it again, kind of falls into this 10% rule, that 10% of the lens price goes also into the filter to keep the quality of the two kind of on a par level and not have a destructive effect of the filter. One thing about this protective effect, some people actually don't really use that or don't like that, and there are videos that show that it doesn't really matter if your front element in the lens is scratched. Depending on the aperture you're using, I think that is also true, but for me, I never use the lens caps, so the filter is actually some kind of a replacement of a lens cap, and I can kind of sleep better knowing that my lenses are protected even though I don't use the lens cap, because the lens cap just keeps me away from taking pictures, and then I have to kind of take it off and I wonder why the screen is black and I forget it and then it lies around somewhere. It's just a hassle and I never tend to use those. So for me, the UV filter is actually kind of a protection and a replacement for the lens cap. The next filter in the list is the neutral density filter. The neutral density filter kind of darkens your image, so you can either take longer exposure, especially for example, making a smooth water shot where you have a waterfall that you want to smooth out, or for video, if you want to shoot 24 frames per second and you want to have the shutter speed at 1/50th of a second, then you kind of want to use those sunglasses for your lens to actually be able to get there without changing the aperture, because if you change the aperture, the focal area also changes, so you then also change how much you see in focus. But if you want to shoot at shallow depth of field and still want to use the slow shutter speed, then you actually want to use a neutral density filter. For example, I have the neutral density filter for my Mavic Pro here, and what those basically do is they darken the image, and you can see that this is basically just, it looks black, but you can actually look through it. And this is the neutral density filter of ND16, so it reduces the light by 16 stops, and I have the 32, I have the 8, I have a 4, and I have the 16. So before taking off, I actually can put on this filter onto the Mavic Pro camera, and then I can film with a nicer shutter speed for the camera. And for me, it feels like this kind of filter actually increases the quality of the footage a lot, especially in the harsh daylight situations, sometimes where you're flying around. I actually got the PGI Tech, and those work great. They are really light and the gimbal can handle them quite nicely. And if you buy this kind of 4-pack, you have this nice box with it, and that way you can transport them really nicely as well. Other than these kind of fixed filters, which are also available for normal cameras, you also have square filters, which you can mount with different adapters in front of your lens, where you sometimes also have this kind of gradient effect. So you have, for example, can darken the sky, but you want to keep the light on the normal landscape. Then you also have the circular filters in terms of the ND, where you can actually turn the filter, and as you turn the filter, the effect gets stronger or less strong. So you actually have a variable ND filter. So you can actually just buy one of these filters, and then you can just keep it on your lens and change the effect by turning the circular filter. That is one of the ND filters that I'm actually looking at to buy. But this kind of filter actually runs around 170 or 150 euros, and it's a kind of a steep investment. And so far, I think that it is much easier to not use this kind of ND filter and just have the shutter speed a little higher, even though the picture quality is reduced by that, especially in video. But for me, I oftentimes shoot at the slow motion effect with 60 frames per second, and there, this kind of effect is not that visible. And for that, the effect of the ND filter is not as visible as it is with 24 frames per second, where I think that at 24 frames per second, it is really annoying to have footage that is 24 frames per second, but has a shutter speed of 1/1000th of a second. However, this is definitely one of the investments that I'm planning to make. Then onto the next kind of filter, and that is the polarization filter. I actually owned a polarization filter around a couple of years ago. There I also had this kind of circular or changeable polarization filter, where you can change the effect, because the polarization actually has something to do with the wavelength and the direction of the wavelength. So it is a sideways wavelength, or if it's a up and down or sideward or like diagonal. It is interesting to kind of work with this effect, especially because you can, for example, shoot through windows more easily, or you can also shoot through the upper kind of surface of water, so you can actually shoot from sides to the water and also look under the water with this kind of filter. I never actually used it a lot, so I sold it again, and it is something that I'm not really going into again. But there are people on YouTube, for example Devin Supertramp, who is always raving about the polarization filters, because it also increases so many of the colors, for example the blues in the skies, the greens in the grass or the trees. It actually is an interesting and really nice effect if you learn how to use it and actually use it properly, and also kind of actually do the work in the moment, because that is the part where it gets hard to kind of keep in mind that you actually have to use these filters, either the variable ND filter or the variable polarization filter. Both of these filters are something that is on top of everything else you have to keep in mind, from shutter speed to aperture to ISO and all the things that is in front of the camera anyways. So keep in mind, if you have variable stuff in front of your lens, you also have to juggle those additionally to the other settings. One last thing I want to stress again, please don't use any of this cheap stuff. You don't want to use a ND filter that is 10 bucks on a camera or lens combination that is more than 2,000 euros. That would be a kind of stupid thing, because again, the filter is in front of the lens. It is the first thing that hits the light. So you actually decrease the overall image quality quite drastically by putting something really cheap in front of your lens. So even if it's just a protective filter in front of your lens, please go out there and spend the coin to kind of get the higher quality product. It will be rewarded with better image quality as well. Now, if you have any questions about NDs, polarization, or the protective filters, and maybe also need some suggestions which ones to choose, please check out the description and also leave comments and questions in the comments area below. Like this video if it was helpful for you, share it with someone who may need some information about ND filters or polarization filters or the normal protective filter. Also, subscribe to this channel for more videos like this, and in the description down below you will also find the link to this playlist where I have all the videos that I'm talking about this kind of video photography stuff. And lastly, I have links to a couple products in the description below. Those tend to be affiliate links, and I hope you don't mind, because these help me make this channel a possibility. And as always, I also recommend you to check eBay for used products, or maybe some kind of forum for photography gear, especially in terms of lenses and cameras. I have a couple really good experiences with used gear, and it helps me spend a little less but still get amazing quality products. And if you actually keep your eyes open, you get really good quality stuff there, and you don't have to spend the money on a new product. Please check out more videos on this channel, as well as the videos in the playlist down below, which are about this kind of filmmaking and photography stuff. I will see you in the next video. Until then, have an amazing day. Bye.